My name is Marianne Schaffeld. I teach at Wood Creek High School. I've been here since 03. I'm involved with different activities on campus that are involved with culture. Lisa and Laura and I have worked on Festival that is campus-wide, and kids come and they get to see students promoting their culture through the kids in the Lisa's program. My students pick a Spanish-speaking country because for my class, and then they understand a little bit more about culture, and it really comes to life when they actually see kids from those countries projecting information about their home country of origin or about some of the activities that they like to do when they live there. So the Conversation Cafe is an activity. They're theme-based on different countries. So when there are Spanish-speaking countries related, I try to send a few students. The students that I have sent enjoyed the activities. They got to make art that was related, and they also had conversations with kids on campus. They told me how much fun it was, and they really were excited about being there. My Conversation Cafe favorite would be when I went to graduation. They had a little graduation party. Some of my students have chosen to be mentors. So what they is, it's a check-off list to check off, say you've done so many community service hours. But when they ended up doing it, it's not what it had really became. It became a great friendship. They learned about cultural information from different countries. They had great bonds with kids on campus that they thought that they were just going to do a little checklist and get some community service hours. My students have grown exponentially by this experience, and they have recommended their friends to do something similar to it. Also, some of them decided that they want to travel and be more exposed to the world based on the things that they learned in their conversation cafes, the project gets, or some of the travel opportunities they have done with the mentor program. Well, when you come to school, it's not just that you're struggling with your language, you're also struggling with culture and activities that are specific to America or Roseville, California. And my students that were mentors helped kids that were from other countries be more involved on campus. They would explain to them what a football game was like or what the rally or why we were dressed up, why we're, you know, black mob. We were all black and we would paint our faces and put, you know, little wolf tattoos. Kids in other countries don't really do that, and I feel like having one more point of contact made it much more interesting for the kids at school that weren't exposed to those experiences in their home countries. It gives them a chance to ask specific questions that they might not want to ask in a group setting, and it forms a great bond between the students who do that and the students that get help. It would be a tragedy if a program like this was not available on your campus. There's all different kinds of ways to start the program. You can do it just in your language class, and then you can extend it to the conversation cafes. When I was an English language learner teacher, I try to do field trips with my students, teach them how to ride the bus, teach them how to be culturally aware of the things that are available in your area so that they can expose their parents. What are we trying? We're not trying to erase their cultural identity. We're trying to augment their cultural awareness in the country that they live in.